praise the Lord. Another hand, praise the Lord. They were involved.
Yes.
Amen.
They were a part.
Yes, they were.
Amen. And we thank the Lord for our youth service.
Amen.
Those that are working with the youth. Praise God. Those that just the church. Amen. Hallelujah. We just, I do thank the Lord. Give honor. Give honor to God, to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Praise God, our First Lady, Deacon Brother. Praise God, may I say to our church home this morning. Yes. God is good.
Yes, He is.
It's just a feeling of freedom in the air.
Yes.
Yeah, wake up like that, just by, I feel all right.
Yes.
Storm came last night, didn't know it was coming.
Amen.
Woke up this morning and said, look like it rained overnight. Maybe that's why I slept so long.
Amen.
We just thank God for another day.
Oh, yeah.
The scripture said this is the day that the Lord has made.
Oh, yes.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Yes.
Praise
yes.
God. Thank God for our visitor. God bless you on this morning.
Amen.
I see you don't see today. Praise God. Brother Anthony came in, praise God, amen, with a good friend and brought out, and God bless you. Hopefully, amen, Lord, allow you to come back, and amen, but as long as you're here, praise God, feel free to be a part of this service on this morning. God bless your heart.
Amen.
Amen. We know today, praise God, is our youth Sunday and youth service. Praise God. Let's see if we have a word from the Lord out this morning. If you have your Bibles, we are going to familiar book in Philippians. Philippians. Third chapter. I'm going to read the Philippians 3:12-14. Philippians 3:12-14. Good, say amen.
Amen.
Don't have a table, but well, the First Lady, if you would read those verses. 3:12-14.
Not as though I had already attained, either were already perfect, but I follow after, if that I may apprehend that for which also I am apprehended of Christ Jesus. Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before. 14, I press toward the mark of the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Bow your head with me for one moment. Father, we thank you. We thank you for your loving kindness and Lord, for your tender mercy, we thank you for your word that was read on today. We pray, God, hallelujah, that you bind it in our hearts and in our minds. Lord, I pray that you move up out of the way and let your spirit have the right of way, even right now. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Amen.
Just want to leave a thought this morning. Let it go. You might want to tell your neighbor to let it go. Praise God. You ever talk to somebody and you thought, praise God, if I could just tell them to let it go.
Okay.
Amen. Everything be all right. Amen. Sometimes it can be hard to let stuff go.
That's it.
Amen. But that could be the best remedy for situation.
That's it.
Sometimes time, praise God, sometimes life itself. Praise God. They're telling you to let things go.
Yes, yes.
Hold on to it.
That's it.
Sometimes get rid of it.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. I remember, praise the Lord, when we got ready to move down to Kentucky. Amen. And I was thinking, praise God, I have to pack up all this stuff. sometimes I'm thinking, just the chore of trying to get everything all packed up and loaded up into a truck. Because, praise God, somebody was buying our house. And Brother Jimmy, praise God, the people that were buying the house liked the house so much that they just didn't want the house. They wanted to know if we wanted to sell some of the contents that was in the house.
Yeah.
And I looked at the wife, first lady. I said, "What do you think?" She looked at me, and we said, "Let's sell it. Let it go." Mm-hmm. Praise God. Amen. Because the boy, this we let go, stay here, sell. Praise God. The least we have to worry about hauling down the highway.
Oh, yeah.
I said, "Man, I'm so old." What do you want? And we went through room by room, itemized couches, bedroom sets, furniture, pictures, all kind of fish tanks. And kind of, praise God, surprising to say, even the dog got a chance to stay at the house. The dog never knew that it would be in the negotiation. But I had to let the old dog go. Sounds funny, but sometimes it's time to let it go.
Yes, sir. Amen.
At another home.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. And, that's how, praise God, life is. Sometimes we just hold on to stuff.
Yes.
I mean, natural stuff, emotional stuff, spiritual stuff, just stuff accumulating. See, the way, praise God, I believe life was designed is to take in and release.
Yes.
Take in and release.
Yes.
Take in and release. Everything, praise God, amen, in life, it goes through that process of taking in and releasing. Until we get to the human heart. We'll hold all kinds of stuff in there.
Oh, yes.
Praise God. Stuff will get the mountain up, building up, expanding, praise God, holding on to stuff from when we were a little bit child.
Yes.
You gotta let something just go.
Amen. Amen.
Just let it go. We had a neighborhood God children. I mean, houses all over in Bel Air here this past weekend was having God sales. 40, 50 something God sales going on. Had some, it may be just me, and I'm not just talking about this weekend, but it seemed like every weekend somebody's having an estate sale. I mean, there's, and I don't know if you know, Wichita and Kansas is known for the garage sales.
Mm-hmm.
Nationally known for garage sales. Even Oprah Winfrey came here and went to a garage sale. I'm like, man. But praise God, I like to go. I mean, I just like to go. Praise God, and go through some of the houses and seeing what's out there. And I found out people have held on to stuff way too long. I mean, way too long. Some of these folks got brand new stuff that was bought back in the 80s. Never opened up, never done anything with, just sitting up there. Now they got it in the estate sale. Now they got it in the garage sale. Now they never learned, praise God, to let go. I seen a couple, praise God, and talk about letting go. Somebody's going to do good. Praise God. Then a couple, praise God, that decided in their marriage that when they brought something in, something else had to go. Until when they got built up to a certain degree, praise God. When things came in, things went out. Things come in, things go out. Praise God. That's kind of a rule of thumb, a decent rule of thumb to follow in life. Praise God. Amen. When you're letting things, praise go. Let it go. So, we don't want to let things build up.
Yes, yes.
In our mind, in our heart, in our emotions. Praise God. To the point praise God, is affecting what God is trying to do.
That's it.
Somebody said you need to praise God. I mean, you're going to get the good, praise God, so to speak, and the challenges in life. Don't think you're going to go through life without any hard times.
Amen.
It ain't never designed, praise God, that you was going to go through. Jesus said, in this life, you're going to have tribulation.
Amen.
But I want you to be of good cheer.
Yes.
Amen. Because I have overcome.
All right, now.
Praise God. You're going to have your challenges.
Yes.
Amen.
You're going to have your times, praise God, where things seem like it's going kind of rough.
Yes.
You're going to have your spaces in life where you got to really buckle down and figure out, praise God, what it is, hallelujah, that God is trying to do, praise God, in your situation.
Yes.
Everything ain't roses, so to speak.
Come on now.
Hallelujah. Life. You're going to have challenging times in life.
Yes.
Yes.
But you know, they say, praise God, even the good leaders, so to speak, praise God, amen, know how to deal with a good challenge. Praise God. A good challenge. Let's look at the verse here, the text that we're looking at. Paul here is trying to make a point about, amen, Christ and his life. My Bible may read a little different. It's a New King James. Praise God. We're going to pick it up at verse 12. He says, not as though I had already attained, either were already perfect. Praise God. Paul was talking that, amen, he wanted to attain a certain level in Christ. In other words, he wanted to be more and more and more like Christ himself.
Yes. Yes.
Praise God. He wanted to be to the point, praise God, amen, where he sounded like a Christian.
Yes.
Where he walked like a Christian. When he talked like a Christian. Praise God. When people see him, they think, that man must be a Christian. Praise God. He wanted to have that image of Christ so deep inside of him that it wasn't no mistake about him. Yeah, I'm one of his followers. It wasn't no deceiving trying to put on something else, trying to act like I'm this part of the world, or I got things figured out like this. No, it wasn't no two ways about it. Amen. His desire was to be the best Christian, praise God, the best follower of Jesus Christ that he could be. But he recognized, I haven't attained that just yet.
All right.
I haven't got there just yet. I still have some issues I'm working with in my life.
Yeah.
I still have some problems, so to speak, I'm overcoming in my life.
Yeah.
He said, but I don't want to make the same mistake over and over and over again.
All right.
I'm trying to attain, praise God, trying to obtain, praise God, that part of my life. One day, he say, I'm no mistake about it. Like what Brother Junior say, I can always go back to the point when God saved me. When he first saved me. When he first came into my life.
Yes.
When he first, praise God, touched my spirit.
Yes.
Praise God. Sometimes I got to go back.
Yes.
Take me back to where I first,
yes,
where I first belonged. Take me back to that point, Lord.
Yes.
Amen. And understanding, praise God, there's something, hallelujah, I'm trying to attain.
Yes.
Amen, praise God. Now, not though I already attained, or were already perfect. Why is there, you know, folks don't feel like you can't tell nothing. I already got this thing figured out.
Yes.
Let me tell you, ain't nobody down here got it all figured
out.
That's it.
If you're walking, you don't have it all figured out. If you're breathing, you don't have it all figured out. Praise God. Amen. You're going to have some challenges in this life. Hallelujah. He said, I'm not telling you, I'm already perfect.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But I got a goal that I'm reaching for. I got something, praise God, that I'm trying, hallelujah, to reach for. Not to, as I've already attained, or was already perfect. If that I may apprehend that for which I am also apprehended of Christ Jesus. Paul said, hey man, I can see, I remember that day when he stopped me on Damascus Road.
Uh-huh.
I don't know where your Damascus Road was at.
Amen.
But I sure know when I first got saved. Amen. I don't know what your calling was, what, praise God, illumination you may have had, and maybe in your bedroom, somebody's church, somebody's home, praise God, on the job. I've heard all kinds of stories when people first come in and first God first come into their life, that different areas they were in, praise God, and a lot of people was not in some church congregation.
Amen.
A lot of folks, praise God, somebody may have been on the street, yes, praise God, hallelujah, with nowhere else to go, yes, and God came into their life. Yes. And all of a sudden, they fell down on their knees and said, Lord, just come into my life.
Amen, amen.
Come on.
I believe everything will be all right if you just come in. Praise God. He said, amen. I'm trying to reach after him that apprehended me one day. I'm reaching for that. And that's why I said in 13, brothers, I count not myself to have apprehended. But there's one thing I do. Forgetting those things which are behind.
Yes.
Woo! Forgetting those things, hallelujah, yes, that God had brought me out.
Amen.
Forgetting about those things, praise God, amen, that had me twisted and tied up,
yes,
that had me all yoked up, that had me all bound up, praise God. Letting those things go.
Come on now.
Hallelujah. See, some folks, praise God, just can't let it go. Huh. You know, this was perfect. This was a good service this morning. It just felt like a service to let go.
All right.
It just felt like a service, just a refreshing, praise God, singing the praise song. The young children was up here, praise God, talking about freedom. Praise God, as the church was going up, praise God, I just thought this is just the right service to talk about letting it all go.
Amen.
Don't be afraid to let it go. See, if you can't let it go, praise God, you can't obtain nothing. Hallelujah. But God is trying to do something in your life. He's trying to get some stuff out so he can put some stuff in.
Oh, thank you.
Keeping the good and letting go of the bad.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Some folks deal with situations, hallelujah, circumstances in their life. Amen. Talking about when they was 3, 4, 5 years old. Amen. What happened to them? How they were brought up, how they were living, how what they did, what challenges that they had, and somebody, how somebody done them wrong 30 and 40 years ago. Oh, man, you should have let go of that stuff a long time ago.
Come on
now. And how I was brought up. Sometimes, you know, I know that stuff is down in your mind. I know that stuff is in your memory. But yes, praise God, it should not have the effect.
Yes.
Praise God, I want you to slow you down.
Yes.
Say, I'm way past that.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah. We know a little story, praise God, about Jacob and Esau. Anybody know Jacob and Esau?
Amen. Come on now.
They were brothers.
Yes.
They were twin brothers. Mm-hmm. You talk about twins being totally opposite? They were totally opposite. One was a manly man. He was a hunter. He can go out. He was like making his daddy proud. Amen. Isaac really liked, amen, Esau. He can go out and do those things, a sportsman. And what you want? You want me to kill an elk? Praise God. He was like the other one, Jacob, was like, I ain't gonna call him a mama boy. But and to put it in a different term, he was mama's boy. Amen. He loved to cook. Man, he could, when you get him behind some, in a kitchen, praise God, so to speak, praise God, he can fix you up a meal. He loved the softer things in life. He understood, praise God, the family life. He understood all these other things, praise God. It's the hunting and the going out in the field was not his thing.
See.
I like to eat fish, but I'm not much of a fisherman. But praise God, that wasn't his thing. Praise God. Amen. He was a whole different type of person. People are unique.
Yes. That's it.
Praise God. Amen. When a person got a talent in one area, if you don't like it, you don't like it.
Amen.
If you talent in that area, that's what God is leading you to. That's what you want to do. I don't care what anybody says. God gives out the gifts.
So true.
But we know the story.
Oh, yeah.
These two rebels, praise God. Amen. Jacob's wife, praise God. Amen. Was saying, you know what? Praise God. You should have that birthright. They got a little scheme going on, praise God, amen. And Jacob, praise God, amen, had a nice little meal all prepared, praise God. When Esau come out of the field, Esau was tired, he was hungry, he'd been out there all day, he was bushed, and Jacob had this nice little meal going prepared, and praise God, Esau said, man, I gotta have some of that food. He said, listen, you can have all you want if you do one thing. He said, what's that? He said, sell me your birthright. Give me your birthright. Esau said, what? What are you talking about? Just give me your birthright. Praise God. And for a pot of stew, he sold his birthright. Never even realizing what the implications, praise God, of that was. For a pot of stew, what would you give your talent away for? What would you give your God-given a talent away for? I challenge you, don't sell it to anybody for anything.
Amen.
What God has given you, praise God, is for you.
That's it.
Praise God, the gifts that He give you, the talent that He give you, praise God, is meant for you.
Yes.
Well, we know how that story goes, praise God. Amen. When the dad decided, Jacob decided this time to pour out some blessings. Amen. Over the son, praise God. How Jacob, praise God, went in there, praise God, and his mother, praise God, got an old hairy animal and put it on Jacob's sleeve because he had smooth skin. Praise God. And sent him in there to his father at that time, because his father was blind, and said, will you bless me being the firstborn? They say, wait a minute, something don't sound right. He said, what do you mean? Well, you need to come over here so I can see what we're doing. I can feel what we're doing. Mm-hmm. And they begin to rub Jacob's arm, seeing that it was a little hairy, and say, you sound like Jacob, but you feel like Esau. Mm-hmm. And he went ahead and blessed Jacob, thinking he was blessing Esau. Mm-hmm. And when Esau finally come in to talk to his father, about really getting his birthright and getting the birth blessing. He said, Dad, you gotta bless me. Praise God, that's the oldest son already. He said, well, son, I already did it. He said, no, you didn't. He said, well, who was that? He said, that was Jacob. Praise God. And that's when Jacob realized, oh. And his mother, praise God, they got together and sent him on out because his brother was furious. I mean, what a gilding. Praise God, sent him on out. But the story don't end there. The story don't end there. Esau and Jacob ran to each other years later. About 20 years down the line, I'm just estimating. But they ran to each other years later. And Jacob knew it was Esau that was coming. And Jacob got terrified about what he had done. He had took a number of sheep, a number of goats, all kinds of silver, and gold and everything, and wanted to present it to Esau as a sacrifice so he wouldn't, praise God, look to get revenge on him. Because at this time, Esau, praise God, amen, had became quite the man. Mm-hmm. Amen. God had blessed him with cattle. Yes. God had blessed him, praise God, with servants. God had blessed his life, amen, with abundance.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Like you wouldn't believe. You would have thought the real blessing did go to Esau, the way the Bible described it up to that point. But Jacob knew that he was coming, praise God, Esau and his band, his family, his servants, all of those that were wooden warriors was coming along with him. And he had to cross over. And he got so nervous, he began to gather all this stuff to present to Esau. You can read it in the 33rd chapter of Genesis. And when they met, Esau seen Jacob from a distance, got off his horse, so to speak, his beast, and started running toward Jacob in excitement that he got an opportunity to see his brother that he hadn't seen in years and years. And he wanted to embrace him, and he wanted to talk to him and say, this is my twin brother, this is my brother. I hadn't seen him in so long, and he was just so excited to see his brother. And here Jacob was trembling. When Esau got there, he said, what is all of this stuff? He said, well, brother, I just want to present this to you. I'm so sorry how things went. And he was like, what are you talking about, man? That stuff, I let that go a long time ago.
Yeah.
I'm not worried about all that stuff.
Yeah,
get about all that stuff. I don't need that stuff, man. You my brother. I just let that stuff go.
Yeah.
He's been hoarding that stuff in his heart for over 20-something years. All that stuff weighing him down. Praise God, he can't do what he wanted to do.
Right.
Some of us can only operate at 10% of what God wants us to operate at because we're all loaded down. We're all weighted down. Had to learn to let go of this stuff. Had to learn to release it. Had to learn to just give it up. Let it go.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. You want to be all you can be, learn to let things go. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Praise God. I know when I was in the military, amen, and as my last few years, as you start getting up in rank, praise God, your years start getting low. You know what's going on. Last few years, start getting a little rank on your shoulder, a couple extra stripes on your shoulder, Anthony. Seems like all they want you to do is go to meetings. Man, nobody dislikes a meeting more than I do. I'm like, I'm going to go back to where I work at, and I don't want to be in. No, you got to be in the meeting. We got work. We're trying to get out, and every Wednesday you got a meeting to meeting. And so you're sitting at the big table, and all the different representatives of all the different shops and different folks, and praise God, the captains and colonels and everybody else is sitting around. And what they do at those meetings sometimes, they get the debating and arguing, so to speak, and talking and this and that, and just, and you just don't want to hear it. You're in there sometimes for 2 hours, and then all of a sudden somebody look at the clock and say, hey, it's lunchtime. Hey, we all want to go. Hey, let's go over to so-and-so. I say, y'all were just at each other's throat 3 seconds ago. Now the clock says it's time for lunch, and everybody want to figure out where we're going. They forgot about all of that. See, when you mature, when you grow, praise God, you understand how to talk. You understand how to debate. You understand you got to let some things go. You don't go away, praise God, holding on to that stuff. And you have to talk. You have to debate. Sometimes you have to, praise God, be open and blunt and plain, and you just get it out there. That's how it is. That's how life is.
Amen.
Praise God, and when it's like, you go on, praise God. Get yourself a chicken sandwich. Letting it go. Praise God. As we understand, praise God, how we let things go.
Yes, yes. Thank you,
Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
I'm about to say, you can only lose the things that you cling on to.
Amen.
Because when you understand how to let it go, praise God. You understand, praise God, what God is doing. Hallelujah. In the midst. And you know, a lot of times our attitude about things, about life, praise God, has a direct effect on our altitude. How we go in Christ.
All right.
Our attitude about our relationships with other people, our attitude about just general life have a direct effect on the anointing that God got on our lives. See, God can't put anybody in charge. Amen. People, praise God, that's put in charge. Praise God. Amen. Understand. Hallelujah. They were put in charge to be, amen, a negotiator. A problem solver, praise God, to deal with stress, to deal with circumstance and situation. Some people, I want to be the one in charge. You couldn't take it.
Come on now.
You can't take folks you're dealing with. How are you going to be in charge of somebody?
Remember
somebody look at you cross-eyed. What's wrong with you? You don't like it here, there at the door? Not if you get it. I mean, really, if you get any kind of a... You know, you can't tell folks that. You got to understand, praise God, how to let something just flow off you.
Yeah.
Praise God. How to let it. You praise God. We don't put the president in office because we think, oh, that's the best looking. I think they can do it. No, we put him in office because we want to save country.
That's Thank you.
We want somebody to praise God that's going to be concerned about, amen, our welfare.
All right.
Not only, amen, in this nation itself, but praise God, every single household.
Yes.
We want somebody that's going to be concerned about it. Somebody that knows how to deal with problems.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah. The higher you go in life, praise God, as you learn, praise God, how to deal, how to negotiate, amen, how to be a problem solver, God will take you higher.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He will take you up. Hallelujah. Praise God. How to learn how to take the good with the bad.
Amen.
How to hold on to it. So many times we talk about the drug addict and the alcoholic. Praise God. And those that are doing those outward things, praise God. But we're hovering stuff.
Uh-oh.
We can't hover stuff in our heart. Hover stuff in our mind. Praise God. Gotta let go of all that kind of stuff.
Yes,
I talk to the praise God folks, amen. Hallelujah. Coming in the church. I say, now listen, you really need to praise God. Let go of the drugs. Let go of that stuff. Praise God. Folks want to come to church, praise God, doing all kinds of things.
Mm.
Amen. They do their drug, praise God. I'm just not aware of like I used to be, praise God. I'm so used to folks, you know, with alcohol problem. That is so out there in your face. You know when somebody's got an alcohol problem.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. The speech is slurred, the talking, the emotions is just all over the place. Amen. And some folks, praise God, when they get a little couple drops of alcohol, they become just melting pots. I mean, they crying over your shoulder. Just some folks are ready to fight you every time they cry. Just pray God for yourself. Praise God. But a lot of this, these new drugs, especially that crack, you can't tell. You think folks just, you know, I don't know, you know, you don't have those same kind of signs. But you have to tell them, amen, if you want God to develop you, if you want to grow in Christ, praise God, let go of that stuff.
Amen.
Praise God, let it go. And let God do, praise God. And he's done so many times in other people's life. So we want to let go. We want to be, praise God, all that God has designed us to be. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's about letting go, the church. Amen. It's about letting go, praise God. And letting God, hallelujah, do what he said. And I think about that verse, praise God, when Paul, praise God, amen, that 14th verse, when Paul said back at the, when he said, I press.
Yes.
I press. Yes. Amen, amen. Toward the mark. Hallelujah. Toward the mark for the prize of the high calling and calling of God in Christ Jesus. Amen. I press toward that mark. Amen. In other words, he's saying, amen, this is like a big target.
Yes.
Amen. This is my target in life. Mm-hmm. Amen. This is my goal in life. Amen. This is the mark, praise God, that I got. Amen. This high calling that God put on my life. See, God has put a calling, praise God, on each and every one of our lives. God has put an anointing. When you come into the kingdom of God,
amen.
He put an anointing
amen.
On your life. He give you favor in this life. Amen. Amen. He give you just the tools
yes.
that you need to make it through,
yes.
praise God, in this life. Amen. He give you talent, praise God, in this life. He wants you to praise God to be, to use that talent, amen, to use the tools that he's given you.
Amen.
Praise God. So that means, praise God, we got to go back and look at and sometimes say, I need to get rid of it. Just like a good old garage sale. Praise God, I need to get rid of these things. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Out of my life. So God, you can bring in new things.
Yes.
See, so many times God can't bring in the new because we're clinging to the old.
Amen.
We're clinging to that stuff.
Oh,
we act like that stuff is everything we got. But once we let go, woo, there's a freedom in Christ. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Once we let go,
amen.
God will take us higher.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Depend on him. Depend on his word. Praise God and what he's trying to do. Praise God to elevate you.
Amen.
Praise God
yes.
to the place he wants you to be. You can do it. Paul got to the point. He wrote it. He got to the point. He said, you know what? I can do all things through Christ that strengthened me.
Amen.
Praise God. I can make that challenge. I can meet that goal. Yeah, I can climb that hill. The obstacle may be looking like it, all that. Praise God. But that obstacle to bow down, praise God, amen, to the word of God.
Amen.
I don't care what it is. Hallelujah. That's why Jesus said, praise God. Amen. Behold, I stand at the door and knock.
Yes.
Any man, hear my voice. Open up. Let me in. I'll come in and sup with them. And them with me. I start a relationship. I start building something. Hallelujah. Sometimes, amen, those that don't, amen, want to let them. I want to let you in, Lord. It sounds so good. But wait a minute. Right before you come in, wait a minute. I got a few rooms that I don't want you to see. I got a few rooms here I don't want you to go into. I got some closets here, praise God, amen. I don't want you to come in, amen. Because when the Lord come in, when he come into your heart, you know what he's going to start doing? He's going to start cleaning the place up. He's going to start cleaning the place up. He's going to start cleaning the place out.
Yes.
Praise God. He said, no, you don't need this anymore. Wait a minute, Lord, wait a minute now, wait a minute. That's my good old chair now. I've been resting in that. You don't need that chair anymore. Oh, my goodness. What are you doing with that? That picture's been up there. You don't need this picture. He'll start cleaning stuff out. Down on the inside. Praise God. And taking that stuff, chugging it out the door. Praise God. Let me see something chugging it out the door. Amen. When he get it all cleaned out, he'll start bringing goodness and mercy in. He'll start to decorate it like he wants to decorate. He said, I got the right spot for this one.
Yes,
amen.
Yes,
I got the right spot for that one.
Yes.
And I got the right spot for this one. And that old chair you used to have, this is what I got. I got a Holy Ghost revival going on in here now.
Amen.
Praise God, and this is what I got for you.
All right.
God, praise God, move stuff out so we can bring stuff in.
Yes, he does. Amen.
Praise God. Those things that God is trying to move out. So he can bring in, praise God. Amen. There's something in the process, amen, of sowing and reaping. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. What a person sow, that shall he also reap. Praise God. Praise God. And we want to sow the good things to God. Hallelujah. So we can reap the benefits. Hallelujah. So you praise God. The benefits of life. Let us stand to our feet.
Oh, bless your name, Lord.